Hey there, fellow travelers, Mark.
And Jocelyn with Walter's World. And today we are in Cleveland, Ohio at the Christmas Story House.
And this is a place that not only can you visit and relive the movie, you can actually stay here.
Which we did for two nights, and it was fantastic.
It was super fantastic. I'm a super fan, and I've dragged her along in my super fanness.
And so are the kids. Like, we all really enjoy the movie, and staying here was just something really special. But we wanted to give you guys some tips and kind of tell you what it was like. So first off, you need to know is you really have to book well in advance.
Yeah, especially if you want to come at Christmas time. The thing is, you can book this all year round, and so we're actually staying here in the summer, so it's probably a little bit less than if we would come in the Christmas time, so do book way, way, way in advance. And the thing is, you can either stay at the Christmas house, or you can stay at the Bumpus house next door, but let's be honest.
You really want to stay at, you know, Mark slept in Ralphie's bed. I slept in Randy's. I mean, that's what you really want. The Bumpuses are cool and everything, but it doesn't come with all the dogs.
And one thing I really think you need to do, if you're going to spend the night here, really take the tour before you go and spend the night, because you really get a lot more out of the stay if you have the background.
Because this house is a museum, you don't get the house all day and all night. You get a portion of the house all day and all night if you need it, but you don't get the entire house, like, you know, the living room and the kitchen and everything. You don't get that until after the museum has closed and stopped doing tours for the day. So you really should be ready to have a whole lot of people taking your picture, or at least be photobombing them inadvertently, because if you're sitting on the porch relaxing, or maybe hanging out in the front room where, you know, the Christmas tree and the infamous light are, if you're sitting in there, you're going to probably be in the background of a whole lot of people's shots.
Yes, but you know what? Being in there in the evening time, we actually watched the Christmas story.
How could you not?
Yeah, how could you not? But you're there and you just see people coming by all the time, all day, all night, people just taking pictures
crazy.
And stuff like this. And the thing is, if you stay here, you get to, there's the museum part where you see in the tour part where you see in the movie, but then they actually have in the attic there's a bedroom, and then there's also
living room and a small kitchen.
And a small kitchen.
Bathroom, of course.
Yes. And actually you can sleep six people, so there's a double bed upstairs. There's a pull-out couch in like the living room area, not the movie living room, but the living room. That's
this upstairs in the attic on the third floor. And then of course there's Ralphie and Randy's bedroom, which the kids slept in there one night, and then we slept in there the other night because we all just really wanted to sleep in Ralphie's room.
And the thing is, if you're going to spend the night, ask them, because they actually change the sheets and put, like, you know, sleeping sheets on there, not the movie sheets during the day.
Yeah, you need to tell them that you're actually going to sleep in those beds. That's kind of important, right?
Yes. So what's cool is when you're in the house, I mean, they do have props that are like right from the movie, but actually if you want to see the real props, there's a museum right next door where the real memorabilia is, so you got replicas inside. So there is a Red Ryder, there is the boxes, there is the leg lamp
there's
and all these things.
There's Liveboy soap. Don't put it in your mouth.
No, do not, because you'll see people taking a picture and they'll put it in their mouth. Don't
do
that.
There are actual teeth marks in it.
Yeah, so don't do that. So like we said, there's actually a kitchen inside, so you could cook in there if you want, but
There is an inn just across the street. It's a bar and inn. We're debating whether it's Rowley or Rowley Inn, but either way, the food is stinking good, and you are in a very residential neighborhood, but having that bar and restaurant across the way is really great, and it is family friendly. We took our kids there. Actually, we ate there the two nights that we stayed here, and the food is so good.
And they're open for breakfast, too, so you can get a good breakfast there, too. The shrimp and grits, any time of the day.
The best shrimp and grits I've had outside of Savannah and Charleston, hands down. I mean, like, excellent.
And get their bacon-wrapped tater tots. They're handmade, so it's not like we were thinking about with back in school.
It's so good.
So the food's there. Here, I'll even show you. It's right there.
So it's a great place to eat. It's good food. The bartenders and the servers, everybody in there was just really friendly, and that's something that I've really enjoyed about visiting Cleveland. I've been blown away by the people.
Yeah, and Cleveland's a fantastic place. We've loved it. In general, for the Christmas Story House, I will say there's obviously, of course, the gift shop that you got to check out, but if you're going to spend the night here, it is not cheap, okay? In the summer, it was $4.95 for one night and $5.95 for the other night, and it can be a bit more.
And one of those nights, we have to say, it was a weekend night, so that was the more expensive night.
So make sure, and if you go online, you can book it on their website, but look and see what dates are available. And it might say a day is available, but it might just be the Bumpus house that's available. So make sure you're looking specifically for the house, because honestly, it was worth every penny. I loved it. I think you enjoyed yourself too.
I did, maybe not as much as you did.
Maybe. But honestly, if you are coming to Cleveland, this is a must visit. Even you're not going to spend the night, but to go do the tour and kind of relive the movie again is well worth it. So I will say bye from here on Cleveland Street. Well, actually in Cleveland. It's not actually Cleveland Street. It's actually West 11th Street.
Don't stretch your eye out.
Yeah, bye.
Ooh la la. It's Major Award.